evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Martin Methodist College. Welcome to the East Campus. And welcome to Grissom Pitch for tonight's 2018 home opener for your Martin Methodist College Redhawks. Our contest this evening features our visitors from Owensboro, Kentucky. They are the Bearcats of Brescia University, taking on your Martin Methodist College Redhawks. Martin Methodist College, the Southern States Athletic Conference, and the NAI have formed a partnership to character-driven intercollegiate athletics. The NAI's Champions of Character program empowers student athletes, coaches, officials, and fans to have high standards and embody what character truly means in a competitive arena. Thank you for your support in this initiative, and please enjoy your time here tonight at Grissom Pitch. Ladies and gentlemen, before we begin tonight's contest, at this time we ask that you please rise. Gentlemen, kindly remove your caps. And veterans of the United States Armed Forces, please render a salute as we honor America with the playing of the national anthem. Gentlemen, at this time, the starting lineups for both teams. Beginning first, once again, our visitors from Owensboro, Kentucky, the Bearcats of Brescia University. In net tonight, number one, Jacob Stanley. Number two, Patrick Augustin. Number three, Kyle Blight. Number four, Lon Yoshida. Number six, Anton O'Reilly. Number seven, Gene Laurent. Number 11, Maureen Murillo. Number 17, Nikola Kofinski. Number 18 tonight, Kareem Ndoy. Number 20, Landon Holt. And rounding out the lineup tonight, number 23, Fabian Torres. The Bearcats are coached by Will Van Nostrand. Ladies and gentlemen, for the first time in 2018, make some noise this evening as we welcome your starting lineup here at Grissom Pitch for the Martin Methodist College Redhawks. In net, a freshman, 5'10 from Deauville, France, number 24, Julianne Grebor. A 5'9 junior defender from Bogota, Colombia, number 3, Juan Yepes. A 6'3 freshman defender from Fredrikstad, Norway, number 4, Harold Solon. A 5'10 sophomore midfielder from El Masnou, Spain, number 7, Mario Lopez. A 6'1 sophomore forward from Bigahin, Germany, number 9, Jonas Harkalayan. A 5'10 junior midfielder from Vienna, Austria, number 10, Alex Kasakowski. A 5'5 freshman forward from Mexico City, Mexico, number 12, Miguel Tezapa. A 6-foot sophomore midfielder from Bela, Brazil, number 18, Gabriel Viana. A 5'10 freshman defender from Cagliano Tricorte, Italy, number 20, Marco Ballerin. And rounding out the lineup tonight for the Redhawks, the 5'10 sophomore defender from Beacon, Sweden, number 22, Philip Malmgren. your Red Hawks head coach in his fifth season by Coach Chris Leonardi, assisted by Brett Berlin and Rob Raspinich. Once again, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Bristol Pitch, the East Campus, and Martin Methodist College. Please enjoy tonight's content.
He's coming up. be freshmen.
Yeah.
Did you score?
Huh?
Did you score?
No. I
That goal scored for the Red Hawks by number 12, Miguel Tizapa. Assisting on the goal, number 3, Juan Yepes.
I got to play striker because we're killing them sometimes.
Yeah, that's good.
I'm going that year. our junior year, we were pitched by a different player our senior year. And, no, it's just the fact that he wasn't good, and he didn't play the full game, and we were getting obliterated, so they put him in a striker, and that was the one time the entire game that we made the ball.
Was that in
Peyton? No, we didn't score yet. We lost like 10-0. We also had this thing where it was like standing player of the game. They would get like blocked, like lockdown player or whatever. And the last game of the season, like if we lost, our season was over. I'm not going to compliment myself, but I'm playing amazing that game. And the whole time the coaches were talking about how I was stepping it up, how I don't want to go home. And they're like, don't even work like this guy. And after the game, the seniors did it because we ended up losing. The seniors went up and like said a few words. And they're like, before Garrison starts talking, I just want to say, this is the best I've ever seen him play. He gave it his all. And then right after I got done talking, he was like, Ryan, lockdown player of the game.
Hey, Donovan.
Yeah,
do I just need to like focus on center field or?
No, I know it wasn't, but you played good the whole season. That was the one game where I played good. I deserved that award. But, yeah, we went in overtime. Was it tied 1-1 or tied 1-1?
I don't know.
It was tied 1-1.
Are y'all bigger than Giles?
Totally. Way smaller.
Who's Giles? I thought they were kind of small.
No, they're small. We're so small. Like, our graduating class had like
I'm a big challenge. If I played varsity at all, I'd probably be
obviously, I'm a big guy now. If you ever play basketball, I'll bet you I'll just call up and throw the room. If I wanted to play like, 3 or 4, and I spent the whole summer teaching myself how to shoot, how to hit the doors and stuff. Because whenever tryouts come, I want to go to the 4 spot. But because I was the tallest freshman, whereas if you put me on, I would be actually looking for but also I just kind of a lot of people kind of choke. So I would have never thought to have done that. That's another thing that I was like, was not such letting go when I was possibly
I have him on.
He
What's the name? Oh, yeah, she was good.
That Red Hawk goal scored by number 7, Mario Lopez.
I think Charles can beat it.
He did so good.
That Red Hawk goal, his second of the contest, scored by number 7, Mario Lopez.
I went and saw him in Nashville.
I saw him at Atlanta.
He went to one of my brother's hometown. He goes. My brother goes to Emory University. Something like that. It's in Atlanta.
Okay.
And they got him to come. Him and the Plain White Tees.
Really?
Yeah. I guess go crazy. Well, one of them was Friday night, of course, and then Saturday and Friday. It was mainly for the alumni because they're too old.
Yeah, because they're my parents.
Yeah, I had to like, sneak in. And, yeah, I had to use his roommate's ID. It didn't look anything like me. There's just no way. Because, like, where he goes, like, a lot of Asian people. And so it was dark. And then he's like, black dude, he was checking and stuff. And I was like, you go up. He's like, yep, that's you.
I went with a couple friends from school to see him. And we were going to bring, because, like, I mean, we're just like teenage boys. But we were like, no, there's not that many pictures.
And that Red Hawk goal scored by number 8, DMA Kalash.
Still,
I
1 minute remaining. 1 minute. Ladies and gentlemen, at halftime, Red Hawks 4, Bearcats 0.
Okay. doesn't have no limit. Your gift keeps on giving. What is this I'm feeling? If you wanna leave, I'm with it.
Make sure you grab something here at halftime before we say farewell tonight. The Red Hawk concession stand is open here at East Gibbons.
Attraction can drive you crazy.
if that's incentive for me. Hey, wanna do something right today? Or we can do something better. There ain't no time like tonight. Maybe you're trying to set up a later. Stay out here living the life. Nobody cares who we got tomorrow. You've got that little summer night. And then some of them on the bar. Tonight's the night, come on, surrender. I won't need your love astray. Yeah. Your love's so weapon, give your body some direction, that's my aim. Then we could take the night. Come on, lose me up until there's nothing left. Take like the night. Dizzy spinning, sweating, you can't catch your breath. Take like the night. Ooh, don't know when the sun is rising next. Take like the night. So get the feelings right, then raise your glass and let's take like the night. Don't try to shut us down. I'll be damned if we go there. Take back the night, take back the night, ooh. You know you gon' mess around and find out there ain't no one there. Take back the night, break it down, break it down.
Well, tell her that I miss all the talks. Thank you. Come on, 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 come on
Goals in the second half for the Redhawks. Number 11, Drew Bradford, and number 9, Jonas Arkelian.
Come on, reflex, keep going! I'm Do you want to go up or do you want to go up?
was going to say, did you understand those
ancient?
I don't know, a lot of people like that, where like, they're just
Right, 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 right That's about like, that's about like, playing FIFA, where he's playing with like, fan on. Coach, and it just ended up going downhill from there. We got a really good pick up at the end.
FED that he's a solid player. And Mike Conley's coming back this year, so I look for Memphis to be pretty good. One thing that does bother me, though, is Memphis is considered part of the Western Conference. Makes no sense to me.
It's kind of like Miami being a part of the NFC East and having New England.
Really?
Yeah. Or, I mean, AFC East.
I didn't know that.
Or Indianapolis being in the AFC South when you got Tennessee, Jacksonville, and Houston. Like, yeah. Miami would fit better in the AFC South, I think.
Yeah.
Geographically.
Geographically. Yeah, I'm excited for Memphis this year, and they just unveiled some new jerseys that are pretty nice looking. I might actually watch some Grizzlies games this year.
Nice.
Right.
Kevin. Hey, and make sure Siri's got a ride. I don't know if she's still here.
She is. She's right there. She said she had a... She's riding on the friends.
Over on our side of the field, so we can't really get over. Over, I'll try and get a kid to run.
Thank you.
1 minute remaining. Ten, nine, eight, seven, six, five. Final score tonight, Redhawks a winner, 6-1. In our 2018 home opener over Brescia University. I want to remind you, soccer fans, MNC back action Thursday afternoon, Thursday evening, as they host Tennessee Wesleyan here at Grissom Pitch. Men's soccer back in action Thursday here at Grissom Pitch. Make plans to join us Thursday night. On behalf of all of us at Mark Methodist, thank you for attending today's contest. Please drive home safely.
Thank you.